As some of you may know, every year I release a video about IFCC. And I also went there this year for the fifth time, and I filmed and I want to do a video. And I've been not editing that video for 4 or 6 weeks. Because I didn't really have a plan when filming, and I also was very conflicted about this year's IFCC because it was so different. So I realized I need a lot of explanatory footage in between to just make something out of this video. And that is why I'm talking to you right now. So IFCC is happening in Split this year, and it's way too warm. Just that sentence pretty much sums up the festival this year. This is gonna be a video about an event changing in Zagreb that wasn't that big of a problem. Me trying to accept that it's different. Everybody dying of heat.
Son, why do you do this?
A bird rescue. Not very fond of the city of Split. It was super crowded with tourists, it was way too hot, and like climate change is real and we're all gonna die, this is the apocalypse kind of hot way. And on top of that, Split is an old city with very narrow alleyways which look amazing. But if you pack the whole city full of sweaty tourists and then you have to squeeze past them, no, it's just not fun. The opening, as always, there was a big, or this time medium-sized, opening ceremony.
So, this is the best year.
And there was a film with a boat, and it flew. But one of the upsides of there being a fuck ton of tourists is that there's bars everywhere. So, real talk, I was super unhappy with Split for the first 2 days, even before the event when we arrived. I've been to Zagreb 4 times already and had an amazing time, and then the event moves to Split. And in the beginning, everything about the event just seemed worse to me. And I also felt super guilty because that was the first year I dragged Joseph along. I dragged 2 friends from Spell Collective along. It was their first ICC. Now thinking back, I didn't even give Split a chance because in my head it was just like, oh, it's different. There was a lot of stress before we went there and there were so many people and loud and hot and blah. I was just in a bad mood. Yeah, so sorry, Split. The event started out super unlucky, but then just the first talk that I went to pleasantly surprised me. It was by Jama, and he introduced himself as the guy who made Will Smith blue.
I was really enjoying myself till the moment the trailer came out, right? This is where every artist faces the truth, right? And the truth is being bashed by other artists.
He also did like crazy magic stuff in, as he calls it, 2.8D. Also, I don't think we were allowed to take pictures, so I might have to ask him if I can show that footage. I didn't think this through. So yeah, I was still grumpy and didn't want to leave the house, but my friends kind of dragged me along and said, let's go to the beach. Beach.
The beach, the beach, the beach. And the IFCC crowd.
So, yeah, at the end, I was super happy that I did that. So, I guess, lesson learned. Get yourself some friends that don't care about your shitty mood. Yeah. Thank you. So the second day started with a talk by Andrew Hamm.
Hey guys, my name is Andrew Hamm.
He is a guy that draws big murals on, well, anything. Mostly big walls. And his talk was more about his art journey and what he's currently doing and how he got to that point. Usually I'm more of a fan of technical talks and not these "this is me" talks. But Andrew had a really interesting story to tell. That was one of the "yay, this is me" talks where you could actually learn something for yourself and also see the possibilities of what you can do as an artist, because I never thought about painting murals, have you? And once the talk was over, we had to squeeze out of the venue and into these corridors to just get some food and...
Hello! Oh, sorry!
He's gone!
Now,
there is no context. I just had this clip of Leon dancing and I wanted to share that because I think people appreciate it.
This is our apartment. So on this ground floor there is the kitchen and a bathroom and living area. On the first floor, this is Philip's and Nina's room, this is Joseph and my room. And then upstairs is where Raluca, Diana, Celie and Renske live. And they have to take that stupid staircase. Haha!
What did we do today? We just had lunch. And yeah, I think it's gonna go back inside and chill, because it is way too hot to just do something outside. Then in the evening it's probably gonna be beach, and or maybe we can find some bar, because we've had some trouble with how many people we are just finding a place where we can all stay. In Zagreb that wasn't that big of a problem, because we had a bar where we could just go and everybody would have a place. But here it's a little different. The whole town is packed and like every bar or restaurant is very small compared to Zagreb. No.
Nah.
She's Mändl.
What?
Dracula, but Mändl.
Sorry, I ate my cheese.
She was being Dracula.
Almost.
Yeah, but I ate my cheese.
On to the next talk, which was also a super pleasant surprise. It was by Peter Han. Peter Han. How do you English? Just imagine this American artist coming up there and being like, yeah. Okay, so imagine this American guy walking up to the stage and just going like, I'm gonna do a boot camp with you now. Everybody got out their pen and paper and he just did drawing exercises with us. Like, how freaking cool is that? So I learned a shit ton from just this one talk and that was amazing. He also offered portfolio reviews for the upcoming days. So next to the one room where the talks were held, there was another smaller classroom. And he just put like times on a board. People could put their names on the board under one of the time slots and then they could go to where he was and get a portfolio review. So that board was always full. I mean, like, always. The minute he put those numbers up, like, people were already standing behind him like, I'm gonna put my name down there!
Yes, yes!
Bam, 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 bam!
Silent.
Oh yeah, in the evening we went to the beach again.
So much cool evening light.
Oh.
animation loop.
I think that beach evening kind of escalated a bit because
hangover.
So it is way too hot to do anything outside today, so Joseph and me decided to stay indoors and cook something, and then I think later today Celie's gonna join us and we're just gonna, I don't know, spend the day drawing, chilling, avoiding the outside. And after that, we went to Anna's talk.
This is the way to the talk.
And she drew a horse. And after that, we went to the beach. Are you starting to see a pattern here? Yeah, I started to see it too. And I think like day three was when I finally came to terms with that IFCC was gonna be different this year.
The beach people. you're ready. Bye, beach. Ooh, the secret pass.
So we just came from the beach and are now going for some dinner. And then we're probably gonna stay home and I'm gonna actually finish my portfolio so I have something to show tomorrow.
So we found this little guy and we were a bit worried that he might be overheating. So I poured some water on the ground, put my cap with water full next to him so he, if he wants to drink something, he can. But he might be hurt. But he's moving now. He was just like sitting there not moving earlier. At least he's in the shade and I think we're gonna check on him in like a couple minutes.
So every ICC, Raluca, Diana and me have some weird kind of adventure together. On the first one, where it was the three of us together, we followed a pink balloon into a random tram.
We took the wrong tram.
That took us the wrong direction. Then we proceeded to follow the balloon for another 20 minutes through the city. Second ICC, we took photos in a rose bush in front of a security guard, after a statue of a grandma had just been lit on fire by IFCC people.
Does anybody have any water?
Should we?
The power of Jesus.
Give me some beer so I can extinguish this fire.
Why are you holding it like that?
He's holding my finger.
Aww.
Like,
burp mama.
Laura said to put it in a cardboard box or something that it holds.
Yeah,
it won't run away.
Yeah.
We have a bucket.
I'm gonna keep it a little bit in the doorway because this lady said not to do it too abruptly, the temperature difference.
He grabbed my fingers with his claws, but he doesn't want to fly, so...
Mm.
Oh, you're more alive than you were before. I think he's getting better with his
tongue. Yeah.
I just
want to
check.
No, he's not. He picked my finger. Aww.
Yeah. Oh, there we go.
Yep.
Oh, he was drinking a little bit.
Drink each.
Oh, there we go. That's very good. Some more. Yeah, he's drinking.
Yes.
Good. See, he's doing the Yeah, he's drinking.
It's so cute, the two skulls and then the bird in between going.
Fuck you, human! Nom.
Not my thing.
Release me.
Not my thing. What are you doing?
He's definitely feeling better.
He doesn't want to leave.
His claws are on my head.
You're stuck now.
This is my life now.
Okay. So, number one, left center.
Okay.
Like most swifts are unable to take off from a flat surface. They need to be on a ledge. Okay. Hence, once grounded, they are trapped and doomed to death.
Shit.
As such, a young swift only gets one chance to become airborne. That's fucked up. You get one shot, baby. You get on the ground. Bye. If all goes well, it will fly non-stop until it returns to breed.
What?
So they basically spend everything, like your friend said, they do everything.
Yeah.
In the air. Take it to an upstairs window and place it on the palm of your head facing outwards. Gently raise and lower your arm, thus allowing the bird to feel the air under its wings.
Okay.
It should then start taking an interest and usually takes off with confidence.
This is drops.
Come on,
little bird.
Oh. That's horrible. How do you get up here when you're so drunk?
Oh, come on, baby.
Don't throw it, dog.
I'm
just gonna wait for a
couple. Come on.
Oh great. Okay, let's go get
it. Bam bam bam.
Damn it, Taylor.
Taylor. Yeah.
But she's definitely feeling the
air.
The air. And the wings seem okay.
Taylor.
Hey,
so
hello.
Pretty, I love
it. Oh.
Come on. No. Okay. She flew. She's down there. Okay. But she didn't hit hard.
But she's down.
Yeah.
And she's in another
yard. But we can get her. We can climb this wall.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Maybe she's too weak to stay in the air. But she flew.
Yeah, but the thing is they cannot
get up
from the stand.
Now. Is she chirping?
Yeah, the thing is they cannot get up from the soil.
From the ground. Yeah. They need to be high up.
We should find maybe like a perch or something.
Yeah.
There's this park, the Mariana,
uh-huh.
That has these these areas that are very open.
Okay.
And I'm thinking maybe we could take her there.
Okay.
I'm just ready for her to, I don't know, in the shade or something. I don't know, I mean, it's wildlife.
It's
So we are going to the park now and try to release her there.
Oh.
She's feeling the wind, I think, the breeze. Yeah.
Here?
Yeah.
So we're kind of close.
Okay, let's just keep going that way. Mm-hmm.
So yeah, hopefully we can find some place.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's the park.
Okay, this
is
nice.
Yeah, and there's more open space. Mm. Maybe if she can get on the current.
Yeah, that's
you know. Cool.
Maybe that was the problem in the yard because there was no wind.
Ah.
So that part of the park was closed and we have to go around. Yay!
Wow, do you see the smell? Holy shit.
Mm-hmm. Park smell. The things we do for you. Ugh. Come on! Yes! Nice! Yay!
She's so proud!
Nice.
Good job, Taylor!
Did you see her go? She was in and then
boom!
Wow! Wait, I got goosebumps! I got goosebumps!
Oh, yes!
Happy
day!
Ow!
What
the?
Oh! No, I'm good. It's not easy being a cactus mama.
Does anyone have any money?
Do you need help?
We got three!
Nice, that's enough!
Go share more. It's not of Thursday now.
Best way to hydrate. So to conclude the tale, we found some apricots. We stole some. Then we got lost. And now we're somewhere where we know how to get back. And we need water. Adventure over. Swoop time.
So hot.
Bye. Swoop. Swoop, bye.
Some late night Jesus. But so when you feel like sinning. It's gonna drive away and we're gonna go.
Woo! Day 5. Yes, I got them keys.
That's very uninteresting.
So day 5 was the day when there was the other talk that I was really looking forward to, and that one was by Ramon Nuez. Ramon Nuez.
Oh. Yeah. I'm an illustrator and concept artist, and also I'll say that it's really important to practice a lot of reality, you know, but you don't need to get stuck there, because from my point of view, you need to understand reality because it's style, it's kind of like eat reality, digest reality, and throw up reality. So it's a really beautiful, you know, quote. I probably will use it for a book or something like that. But
and yeah, it was amazing. The guy was super energetic. Explained how he does his work, and then also did a cool demo at the end.
Dude, it's so more popular than the rest of the illustration. When I post that, everyone was doing meme of this guy. I was like, okay.
Good talk. Super happy. 10 out of 10. The Peter Hahn portfolio review was
not happening that day, and of course that was the day where I finally managed to squeeze my name in there. I was kind of bummed out. It was already day 5 of the event and I hadn't really shown my portfolio to anyone. And usually those are the kind of things I've come to expect from IFCC. You go there, you meet cool people, there is cool talks, and then you also get your portfolio reviewed. Usually we have this huge area in Zagreb where all the people hang out and sit, so you can just sit down and go like, hey, yeah, 5 minutes out to look at my stuff. Also in the evening we always had a restaurant or a bar to sit down where you could do portfolio reviews. But because this time we only had the cinema where it was happening, but there was only the one conference room, there was nothing else. So after every talk, everybody squeezed out of that cinema and then disappeared into the alleyways to never be seen again. And then the only other meeting place that we had was the beach. And I don't know, you just don't bring your portfolio to the beach. It was just a different atmosphere, and now thinking back, it was great. But while IFCC was happening, I was kind of freaking out because I thought I need to get my portfolio reviewed now that I'm older and smarter and know how this is gonna go. It's like I didn't even need a portfolio review. It was just in my head that this is how IFCC is and how it should be. And that was dumb. Day 6. So Joseph and me tried to find breakfast around 12 and we finally found a restaurant that would serve us breakfast. The owner was super nice. So Celie needed Joseph and my key. So she came by to collect our key and then she had the following message for us.
Diana broke her arm.
What? Have I mentioned that Split is an old city? That means it also has old pavement with these stones that every time somebody walks on them, they get a little smoother. Because the whole city is fucking crammed with people. There's constantly somebody polishing that stone with their feet. So the whole city is so fucking slippery if you're wearing flip-flops.
Ah, these are so slippery.
So what had happened is Diana fell down some stairs. Luckily, Leon and Celie were with her. They took her to the hospital. Another friend of ours, Renske, who was still up, also rushed to the hospital and like, ah! This was the weirdest IFCC so far.
My wife's mother like broke her arm the same way, but in Zagreb, also like almost the same situation, like stairs, and they're like all worn out, you know.
Yeah.
And she just fell down like two
it's
stairs.
Very stupid.
Do you have a marker or anything?
That's worse than a dick. So. There's the first bunny ear loop. Then you go around.
Yeah, mama.
Little bunny ears!
Yay! This is stupid.
Yes.
So I finally managed to catch Nuis and had a little chat with him because I'm really struggling with characters at the moment. He had some really helpful advice. And now we are going for some really good food and I'm gonna get Diana so she can come with us.
Yeah, and then we're probably just gonna have a chill evening. So even though Diana's arm was broken, we still got a chance to have a nice evening. We had some nice raw vegan cake, spent some time with an intelligent bench, and found this non-alcoholic cocktail called Pink.
On the last day, we raided our fridge and just made one giant pot of pasta and then did kind of like a buffet, so everybody just got a mountain of pasta and then could just put in whatever they wanted.
One more.
You didn't choose the vegan life. The vegan life chose you.
And then it was time to leave.
Also need to record that shit. Just in time for the film.
We're running this, let's go. Yeah. I'm on a boat. I'm on a boat. Everybody look at me, cause I'm sailing on a boat. I'm on a boat.
So, while I'm showing you photos and clips from Split Airport, which sucks ass, by the way.
So, the flight is already delayed by like 1.5 hours. So yeah, we're having an IFCC gathering at the airport.
I wanted to apologize that this video is so messy and unorganized, but I really didn't plan anything this time, and I guess because I had so many expectations of how IFCC had been and how it was going to be, I kept getting on disappointed instead of just enjoying myself for a week. And I guess a lot of stress outside of the event also added to a weird experience. If you take away one thing from this video is, if you go to any art event, don't have any expectations. Because that kind of keeps you from enjoying yourself, so you're gonna be fine. I'm fine. Everything's fine.